Hey everybody, Margaret here from MargaretMLynch.com, author of the book Tapping Into Wealth, and working really hard on my next book. That's what it's like to be a coach working from home. You can be multitasking in your coaching business and working on your next book. In today's video, I guess you would call this a lifestyle video because I do so much video that I get asked a lot just about how to look our best for camera. And I have to say, the older that I've gotten, I'm in my 50s now, the more fun I am actually having with makeup. I guess that's because when we're young, we don't really need makeup. So this is for you if you do, you're willing to wear makeup, you like to wear, whether a little bit or a lot. I just want to show you the basics of what I do to get ready to make a video on camera and to talk about some other things, like what the camera shows, right? That you have to be aware of when you're getting ready to make a video. So the nice thing about Facebook Live is that I can really like check how I look. I can look down at the image of myself and go, oh, like really bad look, bra strap. This is a big problem for women is sometimes we don't realize and bra strap will show no matter what we're wearing. The other thing is when it comes to our hair, now my hair is super long right now. I haven't had it cut in a while. I don't know why. I need to get it cut. But in the mirror or in life, it could look okay. But see how on the camera, it can look really scraggly is the word. And so I usually keep, which I don't have right now, a brush right on my desk for where I'm going to do video, just so that I can do a little last little bit of brushing if I'm making a bunch of video and I'm noticing that my hair, now of course it never does this, but on camera, your hair will do weird things and get stuck on your earrings. It will also whip forward and get stuck on your lips and your lip gloss, so be careful with the glossy lip gloss, but I'm jumping ahead. So keep in mind that hair can do this kind of thing. The other thing is that often we don't notice in life or if we look in the mirror, but when we get on camera, especially when there's a light background, we can notice anywhere there's like a funny hair that is sticking up a little bit. So again, I keep that brush to smooth everything down. But let's move on to some quick makeup stuff. So what I have on right now is just a basic foundation. I never used to wear much foundation, but as I said, especially on camera as I'm getting older, I do like the MAC makeup. So if you've never really worn a lot of foundation or makeup, especially for camera, oh, hi, Linda Joy. How are you? I haven't seen you in years. Years, Linda Joy. I'm doing a lifestyle video today just on how I get ready for camera. So if you don't really wear a lot of makeup or you have it in your life and it seems overwhelming, you can actually just go into MAC. My daughter and I love MAC makeup. And this is a cover up little tubelet. And so I actually have like a little zit right here. God knows why. Why am I getting zits at this age, right? And so I can put that right on there. I don't know if you can really see it on camera, but it tends to just blur things out, especially with we can get redness right here and right in here, where we can have a little bit of darkness. So that's the important thing to add with a cover up of anywhere that you feel like on camera, you want to look more flawless and it can just do that so easily. And you can put on more makeup for the camera than you would wear in normal life because you can't see how much is caked on in a way and you actually need a little bit more for camera. So one of the new things or new to me that I've learned from my daughter is more about highlighting. And although I don't go into the crazy detail that she watches all these tutorial videos and makes them, that highlighting, especially for our age, is really important. And there's a lot of women in our age group on TV doing this, you'll start to notice. So this is a Tarte palette. It's called Tarte with an E at the end. And I'm gonna use a couple different things from this palette. So right here, you also need to invest in some brushes because little sponge tip applicators for eyeshadows do not work. Okay, so I'm gonna take this brush and I'm gonna go into the darker color, which is the contour, and I'm gonna do that right up here. So I have a little on from this morning, you might be able to see it, and I'm gonna do that right up here. For us, as we get older, we don't wanna put anything lower on our face because it kind of drags the face down. But see, I'm just gonna contour up here, and then they say to kind of pull this down, just like if the way the sun would be hitting me. The fun part of this palette is the highlighter, which I had never used before. And as my daughter laughs at me when I say more is more, more is better, more sparkle. So this highlighter right here is actually, I don't know if you can see that, it's really sparkly. And we're just gonna put it on right here, like down the nose, here. And it just kind of highlights the face and gives us some more light, which is really fun and awesome. And then finally, of course, you know, we know about blush from the 80s. I'm going to use just a little bit of blush. And again, we're going to keep it really, really high, up on our cheeks. Do not come down here, anywhere down here. It'll drag your face down. So we're going to stay up here really, really high. But you can see that little bit of highlighter right there. I'm telling you, watch newswomen in our age group. They all are now wearing this kind of highlighter on TV. And it looks really pretty. So that gives us a more of a flawless complexion. And the highlighter adds something without like just having to rely on like a ton of blush or something like that. And remember that the camera takes color away. So you often have to add a little bit more color than you normally would. And I remember that often when I'm like walking around a hardware store or the grocery store, or I'm out jogging after I've made a bunch of video and I'm like, why are people looking at me? And I'm like, oh yeah, I have a whole face of makeup on because I did a bunch of video today. So keep that in mind. You'll look gorgeous all day, even if you're at the grocery store. Okay. And so if you've never worn a ton of eyeshadow before, the eyes are really important, right? So right now I have on a little bit of mascara and a line on the top. I just used a liquid liner to darken the line because I have some good eyelashes and I want to, my eyes are my feature that I want to highlight. It used to be my skin. I'm a little older now. I have to cover the skin a little bit more. So I like to highlight my eyes. Now, I almost never ever put on lower mascara or liner under here. Why? Because according to makeup artist Bobbi Brown, that will age us as women. It's better to leave this all bare and minimize just the way our eye is drawn there and leave more, the mascara on the top and a line on the top if you want to use a line. But if you're not used to wearing eyeshadow, there is just one little trick that you can do, and I'm going to show you that. So in the middle of this palette is this real tan color right here. And it's probably kind of like skin color. See this one right in the middle? And so I'm going to grab some of that. And you would say, why would you put skin-colored eyeshadow on? Well, first of all, it's really great to act as a base, but I just want you to see what happens when I add just this tone. See how that actually gives me a more, it somehow highlights the eye. Now, I can't see well because I'm probably not doing it well, but it actually does something for the eye. It gives us a real natural look. And certainly, if you are just going to do mascara and you are just going to do a liner, just having a little bit of this really, really highlights it. Just having a little bit of this kind of flesh tone, it almost matches your skin cover. See how it just made a little bit of a difference with my eye? And then I like to come in and add a little bit of color. Okay, so that will act as a base and it'll make all of the rest of your eyeshadow go on more easily. Are you guys liking my makeup tutorial and my note about don't let your bra strap show when you're making video? okay, so I have this great little palette. I just got it at, you know, the CVS Blushed Nudes. It has some great colors in it. And I am going to grab this sort of grayish color right here. And I'm just going to stick a little in here. Doink. Doink. And don't worry if it looks messy at first. I need a better mirror than I can use on my Facebook Live mirror. Just going to put a little bit right here to give myself a little bit of color contour. And that's what's so great about having a brush. I'm using this big, thick angled brush. And I'm just going to move that color around. And you can kind of see the difference it's already made on my eyes. And it's still a very natural look. You know, this isn't date night with David, as I did another video where I put on my sparkles. But you can see now it actually has done something for my eyes. It's still a very natural look, but it's right at this point, depending on how much makeup you like, it can be a really natural look. And really, I always say when it comes to camera, making video, practice makes natural. We are never trying for perfection, but practicing makes us more natural on camera. And it's really the same with adding makeup. Adding more makeup on camera, even if you don't like a lot of it in your daily life, will actually make you look more natural, which is great. And when we talk about the chakras in the first chakra, we have to remember that we still, you know, even when we're in our 50s and 60s and we're PhDs and we're so smart and we're all about achievement, we still have bodies. We still want to be present and compelling and have a presence. And it's fun to actually focus on our first chakra, which is focusing on the first level of ourselves. Our body is our first level, with love and with care and with fun and with whimsy. So for me, since I've gotten older, strangely, I like to add some color. I'm having a lot more fun. My daughter sometimes cringes. But it's not up to her. David thinks I look beautiful no matter what. He's from Jersey. He likes a lot of makeup. So I have this great little palette. As you can see, I've used it a lot, which is blues. Because I tend to look good in the cool tones, whether it's clothes or makeup, versus more like golden tones, which I do wear sometimes. And you can see there's two really light colors at the bottom that are actually kind of sparkly and white. But I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to grab some of that color. So I'm going to take a smaller brush. Okay, and I'm going to grab, maybe I'll even mix some of the dark and some of the light. Now, I don't know how much you will see it on camera, and that's what's fun about it, is that you can kind of really experiment, and since the camera takes color away, you can kind of see how it ends up looking on a video. I did do a video a long time ago, and someone's what, you know, I always get lots of great comments on my video on YouTube, and they were like, one comment was like, your eyeshadow is too thick, and I was like, oh. So, you know, it's always kind of funny what people say. So you can see there, I made a little mess up there, and I like to just put a little bit of color, just kind of like right here. You know, I'm not painting it all in. It isn't actually the 80s, and if I've got a little bit too much blue, that kind of showed up on this one over here, yeah, I can just come back with that brush that had the gray, and just kind of smooth things out. The brushes really, really help you. Brushes are your friend. So now I have a little bit of color in there. Now you might not see me on video and say, she's wearing blue eyeshadow, but you kind of see there's a little bit more color. And that's great. So I'm just gonna show you one last thing, and then I'll show you what I do for my lips, which is practically nothing, is I'm gonna come in with one of these really sparkly whites. And I'm just gonna dab this really white, some of it's pretty sparkly, right here. Right here. Just dab it in there. And it's really lightening up an area and adding some light to an area that is often dark on us as we get older. Thank you, Mother Nature. And we can also put a little bit right up here on the brow bone. Right up here. And so now I've got, it's very subtle. But do you see how I'm slowly making these very incremental changes that just highlight my eyes a little bit more? Now, dabbing the white in here will, if you use very minimal makeup, it actually will look really pretty in person as well. It's a really pretty little touch. Okay, since I'm a practical kind of person, I mean, dark lipsticks look beautiful and some people carry them off well. But I am very practical, so I also highlight my eyes a lot. And again, it's not the 80s. We can't do super dark smoky eye and then super red lipstick. You usually choose one or the other, right? We usually do either a darker eye and a pale lip, or a darker lip and an understated eye. So I tend to go with the understated colors. And there's a NYX or NYX, I'm not sure how you call it. They have a line of what's called butter glosses. I don't know if you can see that. And I just get this at CVS, butter gloss. And they have all of these nude tones, very, very J-Lo, creamy nude type of tones. And I love them. And it just adds something to, you know, to put something on my lips, but without adding a lot of color that I then am going to mess up and get on things and have to deal with for the rest of the day. So I like wearing a nude, and I'm just going to throw that on. Now, sometimes I do a little bit of liner first. But for the camera, it's kind of hard to tell. And in person, this one adds like a little bit of pink. But for the camera, for me, obviously, it's not adding a lot of color, but it's sort of finishing off the look, right? So it's adding something that is neutral, that my hair can stick into, because that's always fun when I'm in the middle of the video. But it's just adding something. Now, looking at this one, I probably would switch to the one that looks a little bit more, has a little more nutmeg, a little bit more brown in it. But I just play around and I end up seeing how I look on video. And then again, as I come back to trying to have a finished look, this is me just sitting up straight in my video. Here again, this is a problem on camera. Now I know we don't always wear tank tops, but everything is opposite. So when you're in the middle of a Facebook Live and you see something off, like a bra strap or something come out, if you're wearing something that's sleeveless, like a shell or something, it's the opposite. Or you see your hair do something weird, it's the opposite. You have to try to remember that. Like, if I want to fix this bra strap, I have to really think about which side it's on. But don't wear a tank top like this. Enough said. The last thing I'll say as I go back to hair, again, around how hair can kind of look thinner and more scraggly on camera or on film than it does in person. So you want to make sure you're brushing it even at the last minute. You can also take hairspray, a volumizing hairspray, and literally spray it up from the bottom, spray like this, and it will keep the ends more puffy than from getting scraggly. But the last thing is that your hair will look more flat on camera. So I swear to God, when I look at myself in the mirror, my hair looks more full, and then I look at myself on camera and I'm like, I look kind of bald. So I know they say the camera adds pounds, but also takes away, somehow it deflates our color and it deflates our hair. So if you are making just casual everyday videos, which are really fun to make from your home office, like I am literally down in the basement. I'm at David's house and the kids are going to be home soon. So I'm just hiding anywhere making a video. But if you're going to make a video that's more professional, maybe for an opt-in for your website, or what we always recommend, a little mini video course to introduce people to you, definitely spend the extra time to make your hair a little bit fuller, a little bit fluffier. You're just going to love how you look on camera. And, you know, it is... It does make you, you know, it's hard to be on camera, it's hard to do video, and you will have a little anxiety, but I promise you, when you look in the mirror before you get started, especially if it's more of a professional photo shoot, like with my friend Suzanne Evans down at Hell Yes Studios, which many of you have done, when you look in the mirror and you look good and you go, okay, and you click on the Facebook Live camera before you go live and you go, okay, I actually look pretty good. It really does help. It really does help being in our first chakra and feeling good and feeling comfortable and saying, you know, I put in that extra 5 or 10 minutes to actually look polished and look my best will give you a little extra boost of confidence. So those are Margaret's first chakra do's and do nots, which I am wearing here, the do not for you for when you're going to be on camera. And so my challenge to you is, why don't you make a Facebook Live? Go for it. Throw on some makeup, get some brushes, get a Tarte palette with some contour and highlighter so you'll have fun looking your best, and make some Facebook Live videos. Communicate with your heart. Let people see who you are and what you have to offer, and show up your best because it'll be fun for you. This is Margaret. Have a fabulous weekend, and I'll see you soon. Bye.